We have health news now. Think your child's eating a healthy lunch? It might not be enough. So the USDA is proposing some dramatic changes to school lunches. 8 on Your Side medical reporter Susan Shapiro is live at the Susan P. Burns Health Education Center in York to show us these changes. Susan.
Good evening, Ron. Well, students may see less of this starchy vegetables and more of this fruits and regular vegetables. The idea is to reduce the sodium, increase grains, and increase fruits and vegetables in school lunches, and overall just make them more healthy and lower the calorie content. We're going to talk about that tonight with Sandy Gladfelter, who's Director of Education here at the center. And we're going to be talking specifically right now about elementary school lunches and high school lunches and how we can make that calorie change. Now, the elementary school lunches, the plan is to make it between 550 and 650 calories. So, Sandy, I know you've got some lunches. First of all, obviously, do you think this change is needed, and what do you think it's going to accomplish?
I absolutely think it's needed. What happens nowadays is that kids are consuming about 30 to 50% of their calories at school, and most of that is not always the healthiest choice, so we do see an obesity epidemic, and in York County as well as nationwide. So these changes are going to be wholesale and be actually very healthy for the children.
All right, well, let's show us how we change an elementary school, a typical elementary school lunch, or one that you came up with.
Okay. What we have here is a typical elementary school lunch. We've got a breaded chicken breast on a white roll. We've got some oven-fried potatoes. We've got cooked carrots or a salad. They can have a choice of fruit, and 2% of milk. Those things combined will equivalate out to about 680 calories for that one meal. Those are a little higher than the standards that they're now projecting. So by making a couple of simple changes, if we opt out with the potatoes and have the kids eat a baked potato, half of one, we get rid of the breaded chicken breast on white, and we bring in a grilled chicken breast on whole wheat, and we give them the choice of raw carrots with maybe a cream cheese dressing or the salad with the low-fat dressing, and take out the 2% milk with a 1% milk. We've dropped the calorie content by 100 calories, down to 580. So now we're well within the limits of where they want them to
and
be.
And you have a healthier lunch with whole grains and lower fat milk.
Yeah, this is something kids would actually eat, which isn't good.
All right, well, let's move on to the high school. Now, the recommendation here is a calorie count between 750 and 850 calories. So here's another typical lunch.
Typical lunch here, we've got our beef hot dog on our white roll. We've got the oven-fried potatoes again. We've got baked beans. We've got our choice of fruit and our 2% milk. This comes out to about 800 calories. So again, not so glaring, but by making a couple simple choices, again, we get rid of the beef hot dog. We'll bring in a whole wheat roll with cheese and a turkey hot dog. We'll get rid of the whole wheat or the oven-fried potatoes and bring in some rice and beans. And we'll get rid of the high-starch baked beans, bring in a healthier vegetable of green beans, keep our fruit, change our milk out to 1%, and on that one, then, we're going to bring it down about 50 calories, down to about 750 calories.
And still a very appealing and pretty big lunch.
Absolutely. So, again, simple changes can be made very easily to have things that kids will still eat, and they'll be able to be healthy with that.
All right. Very good. And we're going to talk to you again in a few minutes, and we're going to talk about the middle school lunch, where you say you can see some of the most dramatic changes.
Yes.
So that'll be coming up. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Susan. We'll check in with you later.